morning all.
Good morning, sir.
So we are discussing about the diet reaction rating. So in diet reaction rating consisting of n number of states, when light ray is incident on the diet reaction grating, there is a bright and dark band sectors. Of course, these bright and dark bands can be observed by on the screen or by using the telescope. These bright and dark bands also contains principal maxima, minimum intensities and secondary maxima. The one of the important properties of the diet reaction grating is to separate the spectral lines, line whose wavelength is nearer to each other. We know Vibgier, the white ray contains seven colors, those are like this. This is the spectrum. Vibgier, what we discuss number of times. Actually, there is some distinction between violet and indigo color. There is some difference is there. So, there is difference of wavelength. But in yellow color, when clearly we observe, there is two lines are there. There is yellow one color and yellow two color. There is one is 5890 angstrom and one more is 5896 angstrom wavelength of yellow color lines. By using ordinary telescope, we cannot observe those two spectral lines are distinct. But when we use this diffraction grating, these two spectral lines also can view separately. So this phenomena is called resolving power. So resolving power is nothing but the capacity of the instrument, to separate the two spectral lines. So our concept is resolving power of diffraction. Resolving power of diffraction grating. So here there is two spectral lines whose wavelength is, one is lambda 1 and another is lambda 2. Of course, those wavelengths are very small difference between them. Then the ability or capacity of the diffraction grating to separate those two spectral lines is called resolving power. The resolving power can be written as lambda by d lambda, where d lambda is the difference between two wavelengths and lambda is the one of the wavelength or mean of the two wavelengths. It is nothing but lambda is equal to lambda 1 plus lambda 2 by 2. By using this principle, we can determine the resolving power of the grating. Now, to observe any two spectral lines individually, according to the Rayleigh criteria, the principal maximum of the one of the wave or one of the spectrum must coincide with the first minimum of the second spectral line. According to the Rayleigh criteria, the principal maximum of the one of the spectral line at least coincide with the minimum, first minimum of the second spectral line. Then only we can distinguish two spectral line individual. So, for example, here this is the diffraction grating. It contains N6. So where we are discussing Fraunhofer diffraction, so the wavefront is plane wavefront. So the plane wavefront is incident on the diffraction grating like this. We know in plane wavefront the wave rays are parallel to each other. Of course, these lines are diffracted through the this diffraction grating and diffracted into different angles. That is called angle of diffraction. So when we observe these diffracted rays or diffracted bands, it is nothing but dark bands or bright bands on the screen or maybe by using the telescope eyepiece. So this is the telescope eyepiece. That is the telescope eyepiece. If this light containing two colors, that is lambda 1 wavelength and lambda 2 wavelength, of course this may be lambda 1 is taken as, that is lambda, and lambda 2 may be taken as lambda plus d lambda. Yeah, there is small difference, that is d lambda is the difference between two wavelengths. For the first wave spectrum, that is lambda wavelength containing, the principal maxima is like this. This is the first minimum, this is secondary maxima for minimum, etc., etc. Here also first minimum, secondary maxima for second minimum, etc. So this is the principal maxima that may be taken as P1 of the wavelength lambda. Of course, if it is taken as the center of the grating, so it is down here. This is the angle, that is theta n, is called angle of refraction of wavelength wave having containing wavelength lambda. So where theta n is the diffraction, angle of diffraction, which makes it the principal maximum. This is the principal maximum. Alright? Now, what is this? This is called first minimum. This is called first minimum. So the angle made with the first minimum is taken as like this. This is a theta n plus a d theta. Of course, it may be written as d theta n also. So theta n plus d theta n is the angle of diffraction for the first minimum. Now we are considering second wave, that is a second wavelength, that is lambda 2. When we want to distinguish these two rays individually, the principal maximum of the spectrum spectral line is at least at the first minimum of the wavelength lambda. Just like this. So this is the principal maximum of the secondary spectral line having wavelength lambda plus d lambda. That is taken as P2, whose wavelength is lambda plus d lambda. Of course, this is first minimum, secondary maximum, first minimum, secondary maximum, here also like. Okay, na? Now, if these two rays are distinct each other, what is the resolving power of this grating we want to discuss? We know the condition for the principal maximum using diffraction grating, that is the formula E plus D into sine theta is equal to lambda. For the first spectral line having wavelength lambda, we know angle of diffraction is here is theta n, that is E plus D into sin theta n is equal to n lambda, where n is the order of the spectrum. So we are discussing about the nth order. And what is the condition for minimum intensity is, that is capital N into S, E plus D into sin sin theta m is equal to m lambda. Actually, that is the principle. N into E plus D into sin theta is equal to m lambda. That is the condition for the minimum intensities. What contains values? M contains actually values. There is no 0, but 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, n minus 1. There is no capital M. And n plus 1, n plus 2, and so on, 2n minus 1, that's nice. Next, 2n plus 1, and so on, etc. And the last one is n into n minus 1, there is no n into n, there is n into n plus 1, etc. It is nothing but the m values does not contain 0. There is no capital N, there is no capital 2N, there is no 3n, and so on, there is no nn. Because all these values valid for the
principal
maxima, that's nice. If n is equal to these values are principal maxima, other than these values contains a second minimums, minimum intensities. Now, we will apply these conditions. For the minimum, first minimum intensity. First minimum intensity of the wavelength lambda. Then what is condition for minimum intensity? This is capital N into E plus D into sine. What is that angle with here? The first minimum intensity makes an angle theta N plus D theta N. That is theta N plus D theta N is equal to, that is nth order, that is N into wavelength is lambda. Wavelength is lambda. That is the first equation. Is it m is right or want to change something? Actually m lambda, that is m is replaced by n into n plus 1 into lambda. Because for minimum intensities, small n into capital N is by principal maxima. Just after that one is minimum intensity. Best just after that one. So this is the equation what we require. And at the same time, at same place, there is a principal maximum of the wavelength lambda plus d lambda. So we know the condition for the principal maximum is E plus D into sine theta N plus D theta N. Because the principal maximum of the wavelength lambda plus d lambda making an angle theta N plus D theta N is equal to how much this is? N into wavelength is lambda plus d lambda. Because the wavelength of the second wave straight line is lambda plus d lambda. So now, there is a capital N, this is nearly equal to this one. If the equation 2 is multiplied by capital N, that is capital N into E plus D into sine theta N plus D theta N is equal to capital N is multiplied small n into lambda plus D lambda. That is equation 3. When we observe equation 1 and equation 3 is nearly equal. Because it contains n into E plus D into sine theta N plus D theta N. Here also n into E plus D into sine theta N plus D theta N. If left are equal, right hands also equal. So that n into m plus 1 into lambda is equal to capital N into n lambda plus d lambda. After expansion, n into capital N into lambda plus lambda, capital N into lambda plus capital N into d lambda. This n and lambda, this n and lambda is cancel each other. Now, that is lambda is equal to capital N, small n, d lambda. What we require? Resolving power is nothing but lambda by d lambda. That is lambda by d lambda is equal to small n into capital N. So, actually this is the equation for the resolving power of the wavelength. Of a small change will occur in this equation by using the condition of the principal maxima. We know the condition for the principal maxima is E plus D into sin theta is equal to N lambda. So from this, N is equal to E plus D into sin theta by lambda. When you substitute this small n value into this equation, resolving power lambda by d lambda is equal to capital N into small n is E plus D into sine theta by lambda. By using this principle, we can determine the resolving power of the KT. Of course, we have an experiment at the disease also.